Thank you. जमिया इस्लामिया न्यू दिल्ली, इंजीनियर फतेह बहादुर सिंह, चंद्रयान फिल्म, सीनियर साइंटिस्ट फ्रॉम इसरो बेंगलुरु, मेंबर ऑफ द बोर्ड यूनिवर्सिटी डॉक्टर आशा सिंह, वाइस चांसलर प्रोफेसर वीके शर्मा, प्रोफेसर
एंड वी फील अकम्पलिश्ड टू हैव एजुकेटेड एंड प्रिपेयर्ड यू टू बी बेटर फिटेड फॉर द 21st सेंचुरी डायनामिकली इवॉल्विंग डिजिटल वर्ल्ड. We wholeheartedly welcome you to the convocation ceremony of Bhagwant University, Ajmer. To begin this auspicious occasion, may I invite our distinguished guest, Professor Ibrahim Sir, Engineer Fateh Bahadur Singh Sir, Member of the Board of Management, Dr. Asha Singh Ma'am, Dr. V.K. Sharma Sir, to evoke the Almighty by lighting of the lamp. Let us all seek the blessings of Ma Saraswati.
सागर के मोती हैं जो भगवंत विद्या धाम है, जहाँ संस्कृतियों का समावेश, जहाँ भांति भांति की कलाएं हैं, सबको गोथे एक माला में ज्योतिर्मय दीप जलाए हैं. जय हिंद से जिसकी सुबह जगे, होती जय हिंद से शाम है. हम उस सागर के मोती हैं जो भगवंत विद्या धाम है, जहाँ जाति पाति संप्रदाय से उठकर वसुधैव कुटुंबकम कहते हैं. ना सीमाएं हैं देशों की यह चारों तरफ, सब लोग भाईचारे से रहते हैं. संकल्पित है जहाँ हर एक जन, शुभ कर्मों से पहचान है. हम उस सागर के मोती हैं जो भगवंत विद्या धाम है. कर्मण्येवाधि कारस्ते का जय घोष, जहाँ पर वेद पुराणों का अक्षरशः पालन होता है. संपूर्ण जगत में शिक्षा की गाथा जिसकी पहचान है. हम उस सागर के मोती हैं जो भगवंत विद्या धाम है, जो भगवंत विद्या धाम है, जो भगवंत विद्या धाम है.
Distinguished guests of the convocation, Professor Ibrahim, Jamia Millia Islamia New Delhi, Engineer Fateh Bahadur Singh, Chandrayaan Fame Scientist ISRO Bangalore, Dr. Asha Singh, Chairperson, Madam Board of Management, Bhagwant University, Professor M.L. Shipa Sir, distinguished guests, graduating students, faculty and staff of the university, parents, guardians, ladies and gentlemen. It is indeed my pleasure to welcome you all to the annual convocation 2023 of Bhagwant University Ajmer. I take this opportunity to thank Professor Ibrahim, Professor Fateh Bahadur Singh, Professor M.L. Shipa Sir, to accept our invitation for being the distinguished guest and the guest of honors of the convocation. Bhagwant University was established in 2008 by Act No. 18 of Government of Rajasthan as per Section 2F of the UGC Act of 1956. University offers various courses as in Faculty of Engineering and Technology, Faculty of Management and Business Administration, Faculty of Pharmacy, Faculty of Law, Faculty of Computer Science and Application, Bhagwant College of Education, Humanities and Social Science, Life Science and Applied Science, Agriculture Science and Research, Medical Science, and many more departments. We offer UG, PG and PhD programs in selected areas of specializations. The number of degrees awarded in 2023 for different UG, PG and PhD courses are 1,055. Out of these 1,055, many graduates have decided to attend this convocation. Despite stiff competition, university has been able to attract good number of admissions and good number of placements have taken place. We have sizable number of foreign students too, from various countries like Sudan, Yemen, Eritrea, etc., including SAR countries like Bhutan and Nepal, numbering around 200 plus. Students have been excelling in their field of education and have participated in curricular activities including NCC, sports, winning prizes, medals and awards. Faculty members have participated in teaching, learning and other activities including research and consultancy. Research work done by registered research scholars have been published in reputed national and international journals and conferences. Our students and teachers have been visiting foreign countries like Japan, Cambodia, Singapore, Malaysia, Dubai, Europe, etc. for attending international conferences. Departments have augmented the laboratory facilities by procuring additional equipments, machinery, instruments and software and computer hardware. Our library has a good physical infrastructure and wealthy knowledge base with books procured from various renowned publishers, periodicals, journals and magazines. E-journals and digital library network is also strengthened. To enable the faculty and students to think globally and give them international exposure, international tours have been organized as mentioned. Overall, the university has done satisfactory work and aims to improve in future years through strengthening its infrastructure, faculty and adding new cutting-edge technology programs for benefit of society. Thank you. Jai Hind.
Embodiment of divine power, innocence and peace. They reflect tender human feelings and emotions and are unique expression of joy that their beauty radiates. I request our guests to accept our gift as a token of our delight and respect. We owe to you for being significant part of this abiding occasion. Now may I request to our Honorable Vice Chancellor Sir to please come forward to welcome and felicitate the Chairperson of the Convocation, Honorable Dr. Asha Singh Ma'am, Chairperson of the Bhagwan Group. Ma'am, please come forward. First, to our Honorable Vice Chancellor Sir to please welcome and felicitate our dignitary Professor Ibrahim Sir from Jamia University, New Delhi. Now may I request to our Honorable Vice Chancellor Sir to please welcome and felicitate our dignitary Engineer Fateh Bahadur Singh Sir, ISRO scientist from Bangalore. Now may I request to our Honorable Vice Chancellor Sir to please welcome and felicitate our esteemed guest, Professor M.L. Shiva Sir, ex-Vice Chancellor of MDS University. Now I request to Honorable Vice Chancellor Sir to please welcome and felicitate Professor Parra Singh Sir, Jowhar University, Jammu. The sculpture of determination and self-confidence who incessantly chisel only the excellence of the individual to declare the graduation ceremony open. Ma'am, do we have the permission? Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you. Today, to bless this occasion, we have a distinguished guest, Dr. Ibrahim, Faculty of Engineering and Technology, Jamia Millia Islamia, New Delhi. I feel privileged to introduce him before you. Professor Dr. Ibrahim belonged to the ETA UP. He earned his BSc Engineering, MSc Engineering and PhD from ANU Aligarh. He joined Department of Electrical Engineering, Jamia Millia Islamia 1998 as lecturer. Professor Ibrahim is an accomplished academician, administrator with a wealth of experience in the field of education and engineering. He has also dedicated 35 years to the field of education with 21 years as a professor, 7 years as a reader and 7 years as a lecturer. He also spent 5 years as a professor of Kazim University, Kazim Engineering College, Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, from 2014 to 2019. Also, he has more than 250 research publications and has guided more than 27 PhD scholars during his career. In over 35 years of vast experience in education, he has also served at various administrative positions. He has held distinguished roles including serving as the head of the department, dean, faculty of engineering and technology, and dean of student welfare. In addition, he has been a member of the executive council, academic council, finance committee, and university court. He has actively participated as a committee member for UGC, for AICTE, NAC, NBA, SSC and IGNU. He served as a member and vice president of prestigious government governing committee Dargah Khwaja Sahib Ajmer from 2007 to 2012. During his tenure at Dargah Khwaja Sahib Ajmer, he did a marvelous job to raise Khwaja Sahib Model School to a college imparting the quality education to the students at higher secondary level. He was also the main architect who got the approval for his affiliation to CBSE. Presently, he holds the position of coordinator, IGNU, Study Center in Charge, Alumni Cell, and Jamia Millia Islamia. I would now request sir to please come forward and enlighten us with your words of wisdom. Please, sir.
First of all, I want to convey you that I will give some due respect to the Honorable Chairman, Dr. Anil Singh, who is not here and due to some preoccupancy. So, but I am feeling it helps rather than the presence. Respected Madam, Dr. Asha Singh, Chairperson, Board of Management, Bhagwant University, respected Chandrayaan scientist ISRO, Bangalore, Engineer Fateh Bahadur Singh, respected Vice Chancellor, Bhagwant University, Professor Virendra Kumar Sharmaji, Dr. M.R. Chippa, ex Vice Chancellor, Professor S.V. Sharma, Principal, Regional Institute of Education, Ajmer, Dr. Amitabh Wahi, Vice Chancellor, Dr. A. Shanmugha Nathan, Vice Chancellor, Dr. Balraj Singh, Member of UN, Dr. Pawan Kumar, Registrar, Bhagwant University, Members of Board of Management, Members of the Academic Council, Bhagwant University, esteemed faculty members, graduates, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, namaskar and very good morning to all of you. It is with immense pleasure and deep gratitude that I stand before you as the distinguished guest on the auspicious occasion of Bhagwant University's annual convocation 2023. This day represents the culmination of years of your hard work, dedication, and the relentless pursuit of knowledge. Today we gather to celebrate the achievements of these brilliant young minds who are on the threshold of a new and exciting journey. Before I begin, let us take a moment to acknowledge the significance of this moment. For the students, this day symbolizes the end of a chapter and the beginning of a new one. It marks the moment when they transition from being students to becoming alumni of this esteemed university. It is a day of hope, dreams, and promises for a brighter future. But as we celebrate the accomplishments of these graduates, we must also remember that this journey was made possible by the unwavering support of their families, the tireless efforts of their professors, and the nurturing environment provided by the institute. Let us take a moment to applaud the parents, guardians, and teachers who have played a pivotal role in the success of our graduates. So have a big applause. Today, I would like to share some thoughts on the value of education, the role of knowledge in our life, and the importance of continuous learning. I believe that these insights are not just for our graduates, but for all of us, as learning is a lifelong journey. In the grand tapestry of human existence, education is the golden thread that binds generations together. It is the beacon that guides us through the darkness of ignorance and leads us towards the light of knowledge. The word convocation itself holds deep significance. It is derived from the Latin word convocare, which means to call together. Today we are called together to celebrate the academic achievements of our graduates. But words carry a much broader meaning. It symbolizes the coming together of individuals, ideas, and aspirations. It represents the collective pursuit of knowledge, wisdom, and enlightenment. In the Hindu tradition, we often turn to ancient scriptures and verses to find inspiration and guidance. One such verse that resonates deeply with the spirit of this occasion is a sloka from the Bhagavad Gita. Uddharte dātma nāvam ātmanam nātma nāvam sādhayet ātmai ātmai yātmo pandara tumev ripurātmam. This sloka translates to elevate yourself by yourself. Do not degrade yourself, for you are own best friend and your own worst enemy. The Bhagavad Gita, a secret text of immense wisdom, emphasizes the importance of self-improvement and self-realization. It speaks to the idea that our greatest challenges and troubles lie within ourselves. In the context of today's convocation, it reminds us that education is a tool for self-elevation. It is through knowledge that we unlock our potential, and it is through learning that we can overcome the obstacles that life may face placed before you. Our graduates have embarked on this journey of self-elevation through education. They have spent years in pursuit of knowledge, acquiring new skills, and broadening their horizons. They have faced challenges and made sacrifices, all with the goal of becoming better versions of themselves. This sloka encourages them to continue this quest of self-improvement throughout their lives. The diploma they receive today is not the end, but the beginning of a new lifelong journey for learning and self-discovery. The role of education extends far beyond the boundaries of a classroom or the pages of the textbooks. It is a powerful force that can transform societies and individuals. It has the potential to break the chains of ignorance, prejudice, and inequality. It is an instrument of empowerment and enlightenment. As our graduates step into the world, they carry with them the responsibility to use their education to contribute to the betterment of the society and the nation in a particular. Today, our world is marked by growing conflicts among different communities, contributing to the erosion of social graciousness. Graduate students like you bear the responsibility of leveraging their hard-earned wisdom and knowledge to educate society and dissipate these tensions. The Indian government has initiated several schemes aimed at reducing these conflicts, exemplified by the motto, Sabka Saath, Sabka Vikas, Sabka Vishwas. It is the moral obligation of all our graduates to actively engage in these programs and contribute their best efforts towards shaping an ideal society free from every kind of communal conflicts. The government of India has initiated many steps to address these issues and positive approaches to mitigate misunderstandings among the various communities of our country. As far as the social platforms are concerned, the establishment of the Muslim Rashtriya Manch has been recognized as one of the best grassroots level forums through which a significant work by the government is fostering a community dispute-free society. Mr. Indresh Kumar, popularly known as Bhai Sahib, the patron of this organization, has made substantial contributions to the cause, guided by the principle of nation first and the religion. And following the existing common cultural analogy among all religious societies of Akhand Bharat, the guiding principle to live together is Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam. The G20 summit organized by the Indian government expressing the Indian ideology. Ayam nishparo veti karna lagu chet sam udar charta naam tu Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam. Today's graduates possess knowledge that surpass the narrow mind versus yours mindset, embracing a broader and more novel perspective where they view the entire world as one family. To reach out the people of different communities and be a messenger to make society aware about the burning issues. And the mission is not just about acquiring knowledge, it is also about the cultivation of critical thinking, empathy, and ethical values. It is about fostering the ability to question, analyze, and adapt. As the famous philosopher Socrates once said, education is the kindling of a flame, not the filling of a vessel. Our graduates, armed with their knowledge, must strive to kindle the flames of curiosity, innovation, and social change in the world. In today's rapidly changing world, the need of continuous learning has never been more important, more evident. The knowledge that our graduates have acquired during their time in this institution is a foundation, but it is not the entire structure. Just as a building evolves over time, our understanding of the world and its complexities must also evolve. We must be willing to embrace new ideas, adapt to changing technologies, and continue to seek knowledge throughout our lives. The world is experiencing a knowledge of revolution, driven by the rapid advancement of technology and the interconnectedness of our global society. To thrive in this era, we must be lifelong learning. This is not a choice, it is a necessity. The skills and knowledge acquired today will become obsolete tomorrow. It is our ability to learn, unlearn, and relearn that will set us apart. In this age of information, we have a wealth of resources at our disposal. The internet, libraries, and educational institutions provide us with a vast portion of knowledge waiting to be explored. But remember, knowledge alone is not enough. It is the application of the knowledge, the wisdom to discern its relevance, and the 8 moral compass to use it for the greater good and truly matters. I would like to leave our graduates with a few key principles as they embark on their journey of lifelong learning. Number one is the curiosity. Never lose your dislike, curiosity. Ask questions, seek answers, and explore the unknowns. The world is full of wonders waiting to be discovered. Second one is resilience. Life is full of challenges and setbacks. It is in these moments that we often learn the most. Embrace adversity and use it as an opportunity to grow stronger. Third is empathy. As you learn and grow, remember the importance of empathy. Understand the perspectives of others and use your knowledge to make the world a more compassionate and just place. Ethical values. Your education should be guiding light, leading to make the ethical and moral choices. Education without values can be a dangerous weapon. The give back. The more you learn, the more you can give. Share your knowledge, mentor others, and contribute to the betterment of the society. As we gather today to celebrate your achievements, I am filled with hope and optimism for the future. You are the torch bearers of our progress, the agents of change, the builders of the brighter tomorrow. I encourage you to view your education not as a destination but as a lifelong journey. Remember the words of the Bhagavad Gita, elevate yourself by yourself. The power to rise and transform the world resides with you. Conclusion. I would like to express my heartfelt congratulations to all of you who are going to be graduated today. Your hard work and dedication have brought you to this moment, and I have no doubt that you will continue to achieve great things in the future. I also extend my gratitude to the faculty, staff, and parents who have supported and nurtured these young minds. As you step out into the world equipped with your education and the values instilled in you, may you shine as beacons of knowledge and be the change you wish to see in the world. The world is waiting for your contributions, your innovations, and your wisdom. Embrace the journey of learning and let your light illuminate the path of progress for all. Thank you. May you all have a bright and successful future. Jai Hind.
Students to please come forward as your name will be called, and please maintain the discipline as suggested. So the first name goes Acharya Harsh Rajendra from Master of Technology. Please come forward and take your degree. Please come forward. Kiran Sothar, Master of Business Administration. Vikas Kumar Singh, Master of Technology.
Please continue frame, man.
Karthik Sakrawat, Master of Education. Alok Singh, Master of Technology. Ronak Prasad Mahavar, Master of Science. Yash Mathur, Bachelor of Science. Bachelor of Science. Bhavika Moriani, Bachelor of Physiotherapy. Ashutosh Singh, Bachelor of Technology. Nazia Begum, Bachelor of Pharmacy. Yogita Sharma, Bachelor of Arts and Bachelor of Law. Aniket Chaturvedi, Diploma. And Priyanka Parashar from Master of Science. Please make a loud round of applause as your companions are having their memorable degree. Presenting research papers, chairing sessions, and delivering lectures. He is a senior member of IEEE, Fellow IETE, and Fellow IE. He has worked in Jamia Millia Islamia, NIT Uttarakhand, and MIT Institute Pune. Due to his meritorious contribution in the field of education, he has also been awarded as Lions Education Award, Railway Board Medal, UGC Visiting Research Fellow, etc. He is an accomplished scientist with a large number of research publications to his credit. He has actively involved in computational and experimental research work. So now, may I request our Honorable Vice Chancellor, Professor V.K. Sharma sir, to please kindly award the degrees to the graduates. Now, it's time we acknowledge the talent. So the first name is Akhilesh Kumar Singh, Doctor of Philosophy. Please have a round of applause, please. Alok Pandey, please be ready, PhD. Anand Gandhi, PhD. Ankit Kumar. Bhushan Mahendra. Vijendra Singh. Bindu Kumari. Braj Nandan Kishore. Chandra Prakash Mali. Deemak Chand Sahu. Dr. Gulzar Ahmed Dar. Dr. Sahabaz Bhatt. Dr. Dukre Tushar Pradeep. Dr. Mamta Yadav. Applause should not be stopped, audience, please. Dr. Mamta Yadav. Dr. Raj Kumar. Dr. Sanjana Saini. Dr. Santosh Shivaji Bansode. Dr. Sinde Kiran Kashinath. Dr. Shohib Sakhil Sheikh. Dr. Supriya Dalal. Dr. Suryavanshi Roshan Rita. Dr. Anup Sharma. Dr. Hemant Kumar Joshi. Dr. Jayant Kumar Maurya. Dr. K. Rajesh Kumar. Dr. K. Jamila. Dr. Kakkar Sudarshan Balakesh. Bala Sahib, sorry. Dr. Mayank Pratap Singh. Dr. Mehraj Udin Diwani. Dr. Mo Asad. Dr. Muhammad Kamram Siddiqui. Dr. Naveen Kumar. Dr. Nidhi Upadhyay. Dr. Pankaj Mishra. Dr. Parvikal. Dr. Payal. Dr. Pradeep Narayano Phale. Dr. Pralap Pari. Dr. Priya Batra Patnayak. Dr. Ranveer Singh. Dr. Rakesh Verma. Dr. Ravi Kumar Savita. Dr. Rita Devi. Dr. Rohi Jain. Dr. S. Divya Teja Banda.
Thank you.
Dr. Sangeeta Sharma. Dr. Sarita Devi. Dr. Savitri Kushwa. Dr. Shikha Yogi. Dr. Suhaib Anwar. Dr. Sunil Kumar Bakolia. Dr. Vandana Tripathi. Dr. Vidhi Rajora. Dr. Vishwanath V.S. Dr. Rohit Kumar. Dr. Anil Kumar. And Dr. Shailendra Singh. Please, sir. Now, we will be having the students from postgraduates. Please be ready. Mamta Rani from Jita, please be ready. Ramjeet Lawrence Meena, Master of Physiotherapy. Madan Ram, Master of Physiotherapy. Anil Kumar Damor, Master of Computer Application. Ankit Kohli, Master of Computer Application. Mahesh Yadav, Master of Technology. Rohit Mishra, Master of Technology. Master of Technology. Rajesh, Master of Physiotherapy. Punita, Master of Science. Jebi Khan, Master of Art. And Kamini Devi, Master of Physiotherapy. Now I request undergrads, please be ready as your name is being called. So the first name, Syed Aman Chishti from BA LLB. Please have a round of applause. Nida Amin from BA LLB. Dia Chauhan, BA LLB. Akshay Kumar, BA LLB. Vijayalakshmi Rathod, BA LLB. Chandan Kumar Goswami, Bachelor of Technology. Kaushal Kishor Kunal, Bachelor of Technology. Saurabh Varney, Bachelor of Technology. Ravi Chauhan, Bachelor of Technology. Marzina Bano, Bachelor of Arts and Bachelor of Education. Mahesh Kumar Gaur, Bachelor of Arts and Bachelor of Education. Ekta Kumari, Bachelor of Education. Ajay Raj Singh Chauhan, Bachelor of Education. Mihir Joshi, Bachelor of Education. Siddharth Panchal, Bachelor of Education. Anubhav Sukhwani, Bachelor of Law. Abhishek Vyas, Bachelor of Law. Saket Garg, Bachelor of Law. Suraj, Bachelor of Law. Anjani, Bachelor of Law. Sushil Sahu, Bachelor of Law. Naveen Kachhawa, Bachelor of Law. Rahul Sandhya, Bachelor of Law. Pavan Kumar Dixit, Bachelor of Law. Vipin Kumar, Bachelor of Law. Bhavin Solanki, Bachelor of Pharmacy. Ashif Khan, Bachelor of Pharmacy. Zoya Irani, Bachelor of Pharmacy. Maha Mudal, Bachelor of Pharmacy. Mahamuddin Hassan, Bachelor of Pharmacy. Nikesh Kumar, Bachelor of Pharmacy. Inash Ali, Bachelor of Pharmacy. Anshifa Pathan, Bachelor of Physiotherapy. Kalpana Aroga, Bachelor of Physiotherapy. Manoj Rathod, Bachelor of Physiotherapy. Deen Dayal Rawat, Bachelor of Physiotherapy. Johnny Karibia, Bachelor of Physiotherapy. Radhikesh Gupta, Bachelor of Physiotherapy. Sadaf Khan, Bachelor of Physiotherapy. Sama Khan, Bachelor of Physiotherapy. Divya Yadav, Bachelor of Physiotherapy. Chandra Banjar, Bachelor of Physiotherapy. Ramesh Kumar Yadav, Bachelor of Physiotherapy.
Garima Sen, Bachelor of Physiotherapy. Afzal Khan, Bachelor of Physiotherapy. Rohit Deshdanti, Bachelor of Physiotherapy. Suhail Alam, Bachelor of Physiotherapy. Mukesh Kumar Godara, Bachelor of Physiotherapy. Ankur Saini, Bachelor of Physiotherapy. Mithilesh Kumar Sahu, Bachelor of Physiotherapy. Lakshita Khachawa, Bachelor of Physiotherapy. Monish Saini, Bachelor of Science. Himanshi Sharma, Bachelor of Science. Basant Saini, Bachelor of Science. Rahul Mewara, Bachelor of Science and Education. Kavita Kumari, Bachelor of Science and Bachelor of Education. And last, Ajar Hussain Bisyapi, Bachelor of Science and Education. Named Shivpura, Balia district of Uttar Pradesh. After his schooling from Government Boys Higher Educational from Port Blair in Andaman and Nicobar Islands, he completed his graduation in Electronics and Communication Engineering, ECE, from Karnataka Regional Engineering College, KREC, Suratkal, now it is called NITK Suratkal, and MS in System and Information from prestigious Birla Institute of Technology, Pilani. He has joined Indian Space Research Organization, that is ISRO, in 1988. He took various management courses, including the management program at Administrative Staff College of India, ASCI, Hyderabad. With his expertise in the area of satellite, PTC, he has superheaded the establishment and operations of critical ground infrastructure for TTC support for India's space program at various locations, namely Kar Nicobar Island, Port Blair Island, Bangalore, and at Mauritius. He is also associated with recently Chandrayaan 3 and other interplanetary missions of ISRO. So we are honored to have you as our distinguished guest today, sir. I would request, sir, to please come forward and enlighten us with your words of wisdom. Please, sir.
Privilege and pride that I am here standing before you on the occasion of the convocation of Bhagwanti University, and especially it's the occasion basically to share my thoughts on this momentous occasion. Today, as we gather here in the historic city of Ajmer, let me tell you, we are not here just for, celebrating your academic achievement. We are here basically for marking your journey to the future, a future which holds a lot of opportunities and challenges for you. I feel like sound has come now. I belong to a organization called ISRO, Indian Space Research Organization, and I present, ISRO basically stands as a testament for the power of human imagination, determination, and innovation. From a very short, a humble beginning, you know about the beginning, only 3-4 decades old now, with a humble beginning, we have done wonders in the field of space technology. We have soared into the stars, breaking barriers and setting new standards in the space exploration. Our mission to the Moon, Mars, and the launch of n number of, or the uncountable number of satellites in the cosmos. That basically is a milestone for the science and technology. But when we talk about the ISRO, when I'm talking about the success of, it is not merely about the science and technology, satellites and the rockets. It is the ISRO basically today, the success basically or attribute this, it is basically the dreams which started in the heart of few individuals and that went on to become, basically a collective ambition of the nation, and we were able to unite the whole nation. Recently we are saying this. It is about the few ordinary personalities in ISRO or in the government of India or for the India basically who went on to achieve a significant milestone just by virtue of their dedication, hard work, passion and never say die attitude. As you, the graduates of Bhagwant University, step out in the world, I want you to carry with you the spirit of ISRO. Let our journey inspire you, not only a scientist and engineer, but as a human being who dare to dream. I repeat, who dare to dream, work tirelessly to realize those dreams and never lose sight of the goals. When you are entering a world, outside the world, outside this particular college here, you're going to face a lot of challenges and opportunities. Sometimes you realize this particular challenge is, it may look difficult to overcome. But remember, even ISRO also had its share of obstacles, challenges, difficulties. But what we did is, we took those challenges and we took in the positive sense and we adopted that particular, we learned from those mistakes, we adapted and we were successful. Now let our journey of ISRO remind you that it is not the magnitude of the challenge which you are going to face. It is basically the strong determination which is going to determine your success in the life. In your life, it could be a personal life, it could be a professional life, you might see a moment where you are feeling jittery, kya karna hai, kya nahi karna hai. And there only you have to just sit there and basically you have to summon your inner strength. Aapki jo andar ki shakti hai, you have to summon your inner strength and keep going. You are going to get the success. Now the other mantra of the ISRO, we call it as a fundamental principle of ISRO success. I'm just telling the case history of it. It's basically called it teamwork. Whatever ISRO has achieved today, it is not because of the brilliance of few individuals. It is basically the hard work, dedication, collective collaboration of hundreds and thousands within and outside ISRO across the country. So basically when you venture the new journey in the future, I'd like you to remember the power of being together, the power of working as a group. You have to basically embrace diversity. And one particular thing remember, you have to respect each other's values. You have to respect each other's strong points and you are going to achieve greatness in your life. Now at this juncture, I remember one of the quotes of one of the greats, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. He said, the failure is basically the first step to success. I repeat, failure is the first step to success. And it is a universal truth and it applies to all of you. आपने चंद्रयान के बारे में सुना होगा, आपने सुना चंद्रयान के बारे में?
Yes sir.
Thank you. So recently we had the launch of चंद्रयान 3 and आज चंद्रयान 3 की सफलता से पूरा देश गर्वान्वित है और गर्व होना भी चाहिए. Why not? with the launch of Chandrayaan or the successful landing at the moon, we have become the one and the only country in the world to reach to the southern side of the moon. I mean, it's really bad. But I know after we stay, लेकिन बात यहाँ खत्म नहीं होती है. आज से आज सभी खुशी मना रहे हैं, सभी अपने आप को चंद्रयान से जोड़ने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं, लेकिन आज से मात्र 4 साल पहले 2019 में वी हैड द लॉन्च ऑफ चंद्रयान 2 एंड चंद्रयान 2 पूरी तरह से सफल नहीं हुआ था. हमारे पास में लोग निराश थे, हमारे पास में दो विकल्प थे. विकल्प नंबर एक था हम निराश हो जाएं, मिशन को क्रॉस कर दिया जाए. दूसरा हमारे पास में ऑप्शन था अपनी असफलताओं से सीख लेकर के हम दृढ़ संकल्प करें और आगे बढ़ें, और हमने विकल्प नंबर 2 चुना एंड रेस्ट इज द हिस्ट्री. सो मैसेज हियर इज, हमें करत करत अभ्यास थे जड़मत हो सुजान. तो अगर फेलियर्स आती हैं लाइफ में, आपको डेफिनेटली आएंगे, तो वो उसे आप सफलता की कुंजी समझिए और आगे बढ़िए. In conclusion, my message to you is very simple. Dream big, work hard and persist even when the path seems challenging. I'll repeat, I mean it's basically a mantra you should follow. Dream big, work hard and persist even when the path seems challenging. The achievement of ISRO are a testament to what can be accomplished when we unite our dreams with relentless effort. I have no doubt that the graduates of Bhagwant University will go on to achieve greatness in their respective fields, much like the scientists and engineers at ISRO. Your education, but remember, your education, whatever you have got, that has equipped only with the tools for success. What is important is, it is your determination, your passion, and your unwavering belief in your abilities that is going to make the difference. So it is, I mean, you have got the education, you have got the tools, but unless until you use it properly, you're not going to be successful. So one of the thing is, I mean, as I said, you have to dream big, work hard, but one important mantra basically is, aapke andar mein chhamta hai, you have to believe yourself, ki aap kar sakte hain, tabhi aap aage badhe. Half the work is done if you start believing yourself. Finally, congratulations to the class of 2023, and may your journey be as inspiring and fulfilling as ISRO's quest for the stars. Thank you. Jai Hind, Bharat Mata Ki Jai. Thank you.
Thank you for your cogent message. Please come forward and have a round of applause, please. Naz Harif, B.A. Suresh Kumar Matho, B.Tech Mining. Manish Kumar from B.Tech Mining. Rahul Deenwa, B.Tech Mining. Tarun Rao, B.Tech Mining. Naveen Dabi, B.Tech Mining. Kartaksh, B.Tech Mining. Banu Patwa, B.Sc Agriculture. Pallavi Jain, M.Sc Zoology. Nisha Sharma, M.Sc Zoology. Nazia Hussain, M.B.A. Sania Dangi, B.Sc B.A. Vaibhav Pali, Mining. Amit Kumar Verma, Mining.
And the last, Rahit Vaishnav from B Pharma.
And now I request our honorable chairperson, Dr. Asha Singh ma'am, to kindly declare the convocation closed. Do we have the permission, ma'am?
Yes, Samni.
KG students, please be ready. The next two rows of post-graduation, please be ready.
Samni. Wait. Yes.
So, undergraduates, please be ready.
Wait.
The next two rows of undergraduates, please be ready.
Hold it.
The next two rows of undergraduates, please be ready.
Yes, Samni. Wait. Yes, Samni. Wait.
please take your seats.
ये सामने आप ऊपर चलो
हाथ हटाओ हाथ हटाओ
वेट
थैंक यू मे यू प्लीज ऑल बी कैन काइंडली टेक योर सीट
I'm invincible.